Good morning. Trying to find a place of less glare is difficult. So I've got my crab and starfish mug today. And of course it would have to be one-sided, so that's coffee. So that I have to drink with my left hand so you can see the cute design. I love cobalt blue, so beautiful. So I have my mug collection, which I just adore. I don't know, I just love little things, you know, and I've got my three beachy type mugs. I still only have 12 minutes. This is crazy. I just went through all my photos, deleted, archived, everything, and I went through my apps, cleaned them out, and I still only have, and I deleted a bunch of stuff, and I still only have 12 minutes. Maybe that's for the best. I don't know, but I'm wasting time. What do I want to talk about today? Absolutely nothing. I don't have a thing to talk about. Oh, wait a minute. There is one thing. I bought a bed. So I've been looking at beds. And you know, the cheapo ones are about $500 unless you want to get something really awful for about $250. And if I'm going to invest in something for my back, I've got to know the quality. Now, I've had the Sealy, Posturepedic, and the other ones, what is it, Simmons? I've had a Beauty Rest. Those weren't bad. But the one mattress that I know of that none can compare with, that I've personally owned and have lasted years, years, without even a dent, as long as you keep them covered. Stearns and Foster. What a magnificent mattress. Unfortunately, they're running on sale, $2,400. So, I'm sorry, I'm coughing. Everything blooming is killing me. So, I was doing errands, and I ended up at the Publix in one end town. Got my prescription, and I was like, I want to go see some mattresses. I was going to go to that Famous Tate's, and but I knew what their prices were because I looked it up online, and they do have Stearns and Foster's, but I'm like, maybe I'll look for something in the 500 range, a cheaper mattress like what my son Dennis got. His is already dipped. It started dipping right away. He accepts it as that's just the way beds are. Mm-mm, not good ones. And I told him, keep it covered with a topper. Your mattress will last a long time if you just don't let your body oils get into the soft part of the mattress. That's what makes it sink, skin and body oil. I knew that because a mattress guy told me so. Because I said, why did they do that? And he said, your body oils. It just, you know, deflates the cush. So I put in mattress stores, and I see this discount mattress. I'm like, I think I'll go have a look. And I get in there, and there's this couple and little girl. She's like, it's just piles of mattresses everywhere in this little storefront. Just piles of mattresses. I'm like, I was going to leave. Because this couple had taken up the entire entrance and I could barely get by. So I went by to the right and I started looking around. I saw Stearns and Foster's, but it was in the 2000 range. So I'm looking and I'm walking and this guy says, hi, how you doing? He comes out of the back. I said, hey, I thought no one was there, you know. It's like, what is this, self-service? And I said, I'm looking for a mattress and I don't know where to begin in here. He said, what size? I said, a queen. And he said, come over here. So he shows me some. And I said, is that a Stearns and Foster's? Yep, there was another one. And so I tried that one out first. And that was, I don't know, $1,500. And it was soft. I said, that's too soft for me. He said, come over here. Showed me the next one. It was firm. a Stearns and Foster's firm. I said, how much? He said, $1,100. I'm like, yes, thank you, God. And then I said, okay, what about, like, I need a frame. And, you know, I was going to go with the traditional foundation, which isn't a box spring, it's just a foundation, just wood, okay? And that was going to be $200 for the foundation and the frame together. And then he said to me, what about this frame? You don't need a foundation with this frame. Because I went and I looked at the foundation, I'm like, it's just a wood box covered with cheap material, you know? And he had a frame much like mine, only it was double, and it was a bit springy, it had springs. And it's up high off the ground, so you can fit things underneath, which is a big plus when you live in an apartment that's small. And so, I'm not crazy about having to get up on it, though I might have to get a little step thing, because I gotta tell ya, plus I need some sort of material to cover around the sides. A bed ruffle isn't going to drop down the amount of length. I don't think that I'm going to need it to touch about 18 inches. But I have my eye on this outrageously expensive, drop-dead gorgeous. Oh, it is the bed cover of my fantasies. It is so feminine, so old world, so beautiful, so coastal grandma, that, which, you know, I hate that expression, because coastal grandma is about rich older women, the ex-CEO of whoever. My vision has always been great auntie's beach house. It was casual. It was not decorated per se. It was little things that they found over the years. It might have been Aunt Molly's side tables that she wanted off her porch. It might have been an old couch that just you threw a pretty coverlet over it and called it home. It's rugs that were handmade. It was pieces of glass off the beach and shells and sand in a bottle and just homey, beautiful things that remind you I live near the ocean. I'm on the Gulf, of course. So, where was I at? Oh no, and what time is it? 8 minutes. I don't have long. I forgot what I was talking about. I need a minute to collect. The bed cover. Ah, I love that bed cover. You know what? I'm going to try to get a screenshot of that very bed cover and I'll show it to you. And you can see how outrageously expensive it is. But if I got the king size for my queen, I know it'll drop to the floor and puddle. What is it about puddling beautiful material that is just so inviting? I love it. I love to puddle. If I had real windows here, I would have drapes that puddled on the floor. But unfortunately, I have a vent in front of mine, and I do love my bohemian curtains, so those aren't going anywhere. And I could puddle something in my bedroom, but I'm not going for that look. I'm going for, you know, Great Auntie's beach cottage. So simple things like a piece of lace that I found in my husband's things, and I washed it up and I soaked it and I bleached it, and now it's hanging as a curtain on a hook, that on a little wooden rod that was already there. That's what I'm talking about. Nothing pretentious, as genuine and real as possible and livable. I don't want people to feel uncomfortable in my home. Sit on the couch, it's covered. You spill something, I'll throw it in the wash. Bleach it, it's white. Those are the ideas and the thoughts that go through my mind. I am very upset that I destroyed that piano cover. It's ruined, and I'm so sad. Dennis would be sad. Dennis doesn't care. He's got higher things to do than worry about a cover lit. Right, so I will put that in the opening photo, that drop dead gorgeous cover that I would love to own. And I just might do it. Okay, so I gotta look at my finances. I just paid off one credit, and I gotta see what the next one is. I think it's PayPal. Get that down, then I could buy that coverlet. Yes, I have to live on credit so I can have some pretty things. And I'm gonna have pretty things because you know why? I don't have forever. I'd like to enjoy it now. I'm not gonna wait for, someday I might need this. Well, someday I might not need this. So that's my story and I'm sticking to it. All right, that's it. Talk to you soon. Bye.